Good evening. Good evening. How glad I am to be here tonight with you. It's time for our favorite hour of the week. It's an hour with Jesus, Yeshua, Jesus. Welcome, welcome.
I want to know.
Open up with. I want to know him and all of his ways, Paul said, in the power of your resurrection and in the fellowship of your sufferings. What a huge statement the Apostle Paul made when he said that. Praise God. Well, how is everybody doing? Welcome. I hope you're doing well. Sometimes I've got so many things going on. Early in the program, I've got to make sure brain is engaged in worshiping the Lord and remembering the words. Always a challenge. Anyway, we are now post-Easter. I hope you all had a good Easter. After I kind of emotionaled my way through, then came the morning last week, I went on to start listening to it by Signature Sound, Ernie Hassan's Signature Sound. And back in 2005 at a live concert in Canada with just mega thousands of people, they were one of the acts, if you will call it that, and just did an absolutely phenomenal job performing that incredible Easter song. And I must have listened to that literally 20 times over the last few days. I couldn't get enough because of the power of the message and, of course, the celebration we were emphasizing over the weekend with the resurrection of the only Savior who lived again and who lives today. All the other religions, their leaders are dead and gone. But Jesus is alive, and that's why we worship like this every single Wednesday night at 7 o'clock Central, and many of you watch it at many different hours across the world. And so we're just grateful that we have a Savior to worship in spirit and in truth. Coming up, first of all, this Saturday, I haven't done this for several months. Liz and I are just going to be available for a behind the scenes. So Saturday morning, Central Time at 11 o'clock, whatever time that is where you are, come and join us. We're just going to open it up. We always open it up for any kind of question you want to ask. You type it in and we'll address it. We'll talk more about the ministry. I'm going to see if I can have a camera handy to hold on to and give you a tour of Mayberry Studios here, this one-room studio where we've been doing this for 3 years. I don't know how successful that will be with a handheld camera that has a cord attached to it. We'll see if we can rig something up on Saturday, this coming Saturday, at 11 a.m. And then not this Sunday, but next Sunday, I'll be traveling out to Denver, Colorado to Thrive Church for a full worship concert on Sunday night. We'll be doing a short package on Sunday morning also, but a full concert Sunday night. If you can make it out there, I encourage you to do it. I think it would be a wonderful time, and I really believe the intensity of the Holy Spirit is going to show up. And whatever that means is something only He knows. But we want to be available for His power, His glory, the wonderful manifest presence of Jehovah. And when that happens, people are healed, lives are set free, strength is restored and renewed. It's a wonderful thing whenever the Holy Spirit really shows up. I'm praying for something special to happen in Denver, Colorado. I came from that area many years ago, spent many, many years in the northern and southern Colorado regions, and have driven through Denver countless times, so it's going to be good to go back and minister there. That, again, is coming up next Sunday, the 23rd of April at 6 p.m. at Thrive Church in Federal Heights, which is a suburb of Denver. Praise God. Well, are you ready to just join me? Don't spectate. Participate with me. Let's make a joyful noise of praise and just give God glory. Amen. You remember this old one? who died. Now you're glorified. Oh, thank you, Lord, for the knowledge of the truth that you are alive and well, and one day will return for us, your bride. Love to sing triumphant, victorious songs like that. Oh, good old Jack Hayford wrote that a long, long time ago. And how many millions of people have been blessed with that song around the world. It was one of those songs that when it hit, everybody knew it right away. And we sang it and we sang it and we sang it. There are a few songs like that in the body of Christ, that when they come with a huge explosion, and people just relate to it so well. And it was such an easy song to lift up praise to the Father. So happy for that. Happy for these anointed songs that God gives to listening psalmists and listening servants. It's really the only prerequisite you need many times for a revelation from God, is to have your ear open and listening to him. Holy Spirit doesn't really shout. He whispers often. You've got to have your ears tuned to him and to his voice. Praise the Lord. It's a song that I learned probably back in the 80s. I loved it. Just kind of came back to me recently. And so tonight, if you know it, sing.
Lord, thy God, in the midst of thee is my
to him again,
the Lord thy God.
His kingdom, there will be no end. Can you say amen to that? The longer we live, and in the natural, the worse things get. And the more Washington in our nation has no clue as how to solve it. And is that ever evident? The more all of that happens, the more the financial economy continues to default and explode and in a negative way, the more we long for the rulership of Jesus on his earth. Of his reign, there will be no end. Oh, friends, it's getting worse, isn't it? By the month, if not the week. But we don't focus on that. If the evening news continues to pull you down day after day, night after night, and the headlines continue to depress you, turn off the TV and turn off whatever source you have for the headlines. And think about the end of the book where we win. And the Savior rules the world that he made with his own hands. Because in the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. And of his reign and his kingdom, there shall be no end. I'm ready tonight. Oh, I'm ready tonight for God to tap the son on the shoulder and say, go get your bride. Anybody else ready? Praise the Lord. Wow. This fits that same narrative. I want to go to Zion.
Messiah. I want to find the glory of the Lord. I want to be with Jesus. I want to go to the mountain of the Lord. Oh, take me now to Zion. Oh, let me find the glory of the Lord.
Sometimes I just sit at my piano downstairs where you can't see and just do that, just play without any direction, just go. And just, it's my little personal way of just ministering to the Lord with the gift that He gave me for whatever reason, I still don't know. But it's His, and it's good to return all the things that He gave us to use as tools on the earth back to Him for His glory. Amen. Praise Jesus.
He heals the wounded. heals the wounded. The palm of Gilead flows down, flows down. Ooh, ooh.
Maybe you have a broken heart tonight. Maybe you've been through an incredible trial this week, or this month, or this year, and you're just not over it yet. Maybe you're still grieving the loss of a loved one. Jesus knows. Jesus knows all about it. Tonight he heals the brokenhearted. Our Savior heals the wounded. The balm of Gilead, let it flow down right now, sweet Holy Spirit. Precious balm of Gilead flows down. Amen. Holy Spirit, just continue to minister peace to those who are in conflict. Minister comfort to those who are struggling right now. Even so, come, Lord Jesus, to living rooms and bedrooms tonight with your healing balm. Apply that heavenly spiritual salve on the wounds of hearts, on physical wounds too. Heal bodies, Lord, just as we sit in your presence. What a healing Jesus I found in you. What a healing Jesus you restore, refresh, and renew. Such a time as this. Praise God. I hope that is touching somebody tonight that needs it. Hey, for more music of instrumental nature like this, if you haven't known yet, I just released a couple weeks ago Night Sounds 2, about 97 minutes of instrumental, peaceful music. It's called In the Quiet, this version, and I believe it will help you at night get to sleep, accompany you as you're studying the Word or reading a good book, or provide background music if you're having some folks over for dinner or just whatever. I hope it'll be a blessing to you. There's been about 10,000 listens already on that, and so we're thankful that it's being a blessing to people tonight. Just want to share for a few minutes tonight a couple things I learned from two different homeless men. I used to have, back in Colorado, we had a large ministry, large enough that we could bless people at Christmas time with gift cards. We would give $1,000 gift cards to needy families, to Walmart, so they could go there and buy groceries, they could buy clothing for their kids, they could buy other kinds of supplies for school or whatever. And it was always the joy of our staff to go Christmas caroling to seven different families and give them each $1,000 gift card, and to see them light up, because most of these people weren't going to have any Christmas, let alone a good Christmas. And I'm telling you, it is so much more blessed to give than receive. Well, anyway, some of you know I went through a real difficult time and shut that arm of ministry down and just left ministry altogether. And moved to a different town to try to regroup my life. But in the midst of that, I was feeling so bad that I couldn't give away large sums of money, and I still wanted to be a blessing in some way. So I took some $20 bills, about five of them. I scraped up $100 and went to downtown Nashville, where I was living at the time. Wasn't living in downtown Nashville, but I drove into Nashville from a suburb. And I found a guy on a street corner, actually a nice-looking guy, probably not more than 35 years old. And it was like, this is who I need to give one of these $20 bills to. Put down my window, and I said, "Hello, sir, how you doing?" Here's what he said to me. Touches me to this day. Here's what he said. "I'm just trying to find my way home." If that was not a message from God for me, and let's take it one step further. I don't know most of you. I don't know most of mankind. Let me tell you what every single person who has a whole mind is trying to do on this earth. We're just trying to find our way home. So I left that man on the street corner much richer in my own heart. He was incredibly grateful for a $20 bill. I think most of the time he gets a buck, maybe $5. I don't know. But with that in mind, I want to share a couple things because of the day we're living in, and I've shared things like this before. But I can't overemphasize it because of the intensity of the attack of the prince of the power of the air, and how it's infiltrating its way into churches, and many of the elect are not even aware of it, do not perceive of it because of the trust issue. I forgot one of the props. I was going to bring 5 different colored golf balls up here tonight. Doggone it. They're down in the garage, baby, by my golf clubs. Could you get them? I mean, it really means a lot. Or just bring one of each color, whatever's in that wire bucket. The styrofoam, rubber ones. My trusty assistant, who has left her producing job for a moment to go down to the garage. You will get this better if there is an object lesson attached to it, all right? So be patient with us here. So with that in mind, that we're all just trying to find our way home. Matthew 10:16. Jesus says this, "Behold, I send you out as sheep in the midst of wolves. Therefore, be wise as serpents and harmless as doves." I've quoted this to you more than once. This is the day and age when you can't just serve God like you did with mommy and daddy when you were little, because everything is changing. Social media is changing how we think, how we speak, how we react. The spirit of fear has been loosed on the planet 3 years ago. Okay. Thank you, baby. I'm going to take a yellow one. All right. All right. That was Matthew 10:16. 1 Timothy 4:1. Now the Holy Spirit tells us clearly that in the last times, some will turn away from the true faith. They will follow deceptive spirits and teachings that come from demons. Now let me tell you about our adversary for a moment. Here's what our adversary does to try to suck you in. He says, "Hey, this is a red ball. Look at it. This is a red ball." And I don't know if the camera is truly interpreting that as true red, but it is. Here in the studio, this is truly a red ball. "This is a yellow ball," the enemy will say to you. "This is a yellow ball." See, I'm speaking truth. This is what happened in the garden. "This is a blue ball, saint." Notice its blueness. You can't mistake that. This is a blue ball. Then he comes to this and he goes, "This is a tan ball. It's kind of beige, kind of a camel color." And you go, "Well, I don't know. He was right on the red ball and the yellow ball and the blue ball, I guess. I don't know. Maybe that is kind of a cream, kind of a beige." And when he can do that, he's got an inroad into your heart. I was listening to a pastor on YouTube earlier in the day. A man who really knows the word. But he started talking about progressive Christianity and perhaps people who are condemned to hell are only condemned to hell for a short period of time until they have opened their eyes and learned a lesson. And first of all, I just want to stop the recording and just say, that's just ridiculous. But I'm thinking, there are many people listening to this. I saw another pastor who is a pastor of a super mega church and just recently was speaking in another church that is pastored by somebody that I would never, ever put my stamp on. Just blew me out of the water. And the Holy Spirit whispered to me, be wise as serpents, but gentle as doves. For in the last times, some will turn away from true faith. They will follow, listen, they will follow deceptive spirits and teachings that come from demons. Doesn't look like a demon. Says all the right things. Has a big church. What about when we see false prophets and false Christ, the word says, in the last days, who do miracles? What about then? That says, the scripture goes on to say that even the elect, if possible, would be deceived. Friends, we're living in that time. And I don't even mean to shame some of these people I just did not mention the name but talked about because they're not even aware of what they're doing. They're being drawn away in their desire to take you to a higher place. They're listening to something or they're being led by a demon spirit that is leading them astray, and then they in turn lead the sheep, the flock, astray. And what's the flock do? Well, he was right about the red ball, and he was right about the yellow and the blue ball, so he must be right about this. But discern the spirits. Look past that deliverer of that message and seek out the Holy Spirit's wisdom. We've got to be wise. It's not going to get any easier. The forces of darkness are turning up the intensity. Don't focus on that. Focus on the truth of the word. Now, the second homeless guy, I'm in South Africa, sitting outside enjoying a nice day. And here comes this young guy, probably no more than 23, 24 years old. He walks up to me and he said, excuse me, sir, but I was just praying and I felt like God told me to ask you if you could give me some help with some money so that I could buy a meal. And I sat there and I looked at him and I thought, this is one of two things. Either a sell job because it's convenient to use the name of the Lord, or this is the real deal. So here's what I said. Who is Jesus to you? And it took him back for a second. He didn't think that was coming out. He thought I was going to say, no, can't help you. Move on, please. I said, who is Jesus to you? And his eyes kind of opened up bright. And he said, Jesus, he's the Son of God. And he took my place and died for my sins. I said, young man, that is the right answer. And the Holy Spirit said, wide is the road to destruction, narrow is the road to heaven, and this young man is on the right road. And I gave him what I could. And it couldn't have been in South African money. It couldn't have been more than $5. You'd have thought I just emptied my bank account. He took off going, God is good. All the time, God is good. It blessed me so much. But the Holy Spirit said, that's the road right there. Don't look to the left or the right. Don't expand your theology to include progressive Christianity, because he was the same yesterday, today, and forever, and always will be that same Jesus. The word that was written way back is still the word. We don't need to expand upon it. We don't need to embellish it. We need to serve him, because he died on the cross for my sin, past, present, and forever. And if I believe in him and the work that he did, and I follow him, I will reign with him in glory someday. Hallelujah. It's been wonderful being with you tonight. I hope someplace during the last hour, the Holy Spirit has ministered to your life. It's a joy to share this hour with you. Don't forget, a week from Sunday in Denver, Colorado at Thrive Church. And don't forget, this Saturday morning, come and join us. We'll just talk about the things of the Lord behind the scenes at an hour with Jesus. Until then, for Liz and myself, thanks so much for joining us. We love you and we bless you. And bye-bye for now.